In this tutorial, we're going to install Python onto the Windows operating system. The burning question here is probably, why do I need to install Python? The whole point of downloading Python is that it provides us all the tools that allows the computer to interact with the Python programming language so that it can execute our code or run our code. This is Windows 11. This process should work on Windows 10, so you can follow along if you're running Windows 10 or 11. So here I have a fresh installation of Windows 11. So let's go ahead and open up a browser window, go over to Google, and let's type in Python download. So there is only one place where we want to download Python safely, and that is the python.org website. So let's head over to python.org. You can go there directly. And let's go over to downloads. So you can see by default, when you navigate or land on the page, we are presented with the Python download, and that is the latest version. So for this course, I am running 3.9.5, but if you're running Windows, you can run any version of Python from about 3.4. So let's head over to the download section. Let's go to Windows and have a look at the different options here. Now, we've already noticed that there are different versions of Python. Python is a very proactive language, which is constantly being updated. Although at the moment, that's not necessarily an important factor, but later along the line in your development, you may be working with legacy software. That software may be written with older versions of Python. So you may have a need in the future to download different versions and use different versions of Python when developing applications. For this course, all the examples are demonstrated utilizing Python 3.9.5. And although I suggested that that isn't necessarily an issue if you're running later or earlier versions of Python, for this particular course, if you do want to follow along and download that version, let's go ahead and search this page here for 3.9.5 and download the correct version. Okay, so clicking on the link here, we're presented with a few different options. At the bottom here, we can download the 64-bit or 32-bit option. Now, if you're running in a computer that's been purchased over the last, say, 10 years, then the likelihood is that you're running a 64-bit machine. So you go ahead and download 64-bit. Once you've downloaded Python, let's just go ahead and open the file. It will be downloaded, no doubt, to the download folder if you don't have this particular operating system. So here we're presented with two options, install now and customize installation. The first option that you should select is to add Python 3.9 to path. So by adding Python to path, it makes it possible for you to run or use Python from your command prompt. And that is something that we want to do. So let's make sure that we add and select that option. Secondly, I just want to customize where we are going to actually install Python. Because, for example, here you can see that it's going to be installed in this location here. But potentially that isn't necessarily a very convenient place where I want to actually store the Python installation. Because if I've got multiple versions of Python, maybe I want to be able to easily access those different versions. So I like to install Python directly onto the C drive. So we can ignore this list here. We can install everything. That isn't a problem for this particular course. So I press next. And then here, customize the installation. I'm just going to remove everything and then make sure that then that is then installed onto the C drive in a folder called Python 3.9, referencing the version of Python. So you can decide if you want to install for all users. But like I said, there isn't really anything else here that we need to consider for this particular course. So you can just go ahead now and install. So do you want to make changes? Yes. So once we're finished, we're told it was successful. So everything should be absolutely fine. So we just close that installer. It looks like I've opened it up twice. Now, if you do have any problems with installing Python, then head over to Stack Overflow. If you haven't been introduced or seen Stack Overflow before, it is a service whereby you can ask technical questions. If you're having problems with a software installation, maybe you're having problems with some code that you're working on, then definitely have a look at Stack Overflow, because generally 99% of the time, the problems that you're experiencing, someone else has already experienced those. So it's likely to be a resolution for that problem here. So let's just check that Python has been installed. So we can go over to start. Let's type in the word command. That should bring up the command prompt here, or give us the option to open up the command prompt. And then from inside the command prompt, I'm going to type in py for Python space dash dash and then version. So that's going to tell me that Python 3.95 is now installed on the computer. With Python now installed, we're now ready to develop and execute or run our applications in Python.